the spent uranium at Callaway being safely stored?
Yes, all the fuel from Callaway since day one is stored in a scientifically designed building designed for the worst case natural hazards for our area. That building is approximately 2 feet thick, reinforced concrete. That's the outside wall. The pool that contains the fuel is, the wall thickness varies between 6 and 8 feet, and it sits on a 6 feet thick base mat. Stainless steel lined, no drain in the bottom, so you can't drain the water out. No way to siphon it out because all the piping hooks to it has siphon breakers. And our industry has safely managed spent nuclear fuel since 1957. And just to carry that a bit further, it's not like the U.S. power industry didn't have a plan for spent nuclear fuel. You know, our plant went online in 1984, and we signed a contract with the Department of Energy in accordance with federal law. We didn't have any option. You have to sign if you want a license that they take responsibility for the fuel. It's the law of the land. And our industry has done that across all 104 plants. And we've paid the Department of Energy over $31 billion to take that fuel and are still waiting for them to fulfill their obligation.
When Mr. Bond says we've paid the NRC $30 billion, he means ratepayers from utilities that chose to build nuclear reactors have paid the NRC $30 billion.
It's Department of Energy.
Department of Energy. My apologies.
And that's correct. Those funds are part of what you pay as your local rates.
You can count that as a surcharge for